Friday, September 18th, 2009, and this is your daily dose. We're going to jump right in. I just want to go, everybody, we are adding something new today. Along with the daily quotes, we're also going to have like a daily activity to do to help further and advance and educate and inform about the Medical Marijuana Patient Registry Card Program here in Nevada. Today, what I'm asking you to do is to call up Sheriff Gillespie, basically the public information officer. That's the number I have up there. Call up Sheriff Gillespie and ask him to make sure that at the academy and during pre-shifts, whatever you call them in the police world, whenever they're debriefing, however you call it, members of Las Vegas Metro Police Department need to be told about NRS 453A. The number to reach them at, and this is for the Public Information Office, so that you can try to speak with our sheriff, who's an elected official. You are a constituent. And it's 702-838-3394. So today I'm asking people to call our sheriff's office and let them know that we'd like for our police department to be informed about the medical marijuana program so that our patients will stop being harassed when they're pulled over. I actually have testimony in my hand of a patient that had this happen to him. But please call the sheriff's office. Let them know we'd like for our police department to be made aware of this law and to understand it and to actually be exposed to the paperwork. And if they can't do that, I'll be more than happy to go down and show them. Now, got your daily activity to further advance, educate, and inform. We're going to get into the quotes. And these are pretty interesting today, but they'll very much apply, and I'm going to end up reading a passage from a book. The first one says, "Don't tell a woman she's pretty. Tell her there is no other woman in the world like her, and all roads will open to you." The next one says, "Laziness is nothing more than the habit of resting before you get tired." And then the last one today, and this is another one of my favorites. You know, I saved my favorite of the day for the last one, and it says, "It is not how old you are, but how you are old." And that's going to go right into this. This book is called Seeds of Greatness. And see the author, The 10 Best Secrets of Success. And there's a passage in here. And the author is talking about an experience he had with his grandmother. And they used to take the ferries from Coronado Island to San Diego. I believe that's where that's at. And he had conversations because back in the 40s, obviously, you know, with the bombing of Pearl Harbor and things of that nature, San Diego used to have like sirens and raids like that in case there would be like a sea attack on California. Well, he talks about, you know, some things that he said, you know, like, "Do you think we'll lose?" So on and so forth. "Do you think the Japanese Empire will get us?" Well, and here's a copy. And it talks about how the grandmother went back into a room and had grabbed a copy of a speech. And back then, they didn't have TV, they had radio, you know, and so all they had back then was intellectual conversation, you know, people talking, people integrating, you know. There wasn't mass media as much as there is now, you know. It was pretty much just, the newspaper was about as big as it got, radio programming. But she read this speech, and it was basically broadcast on the radio by Madam Chiang Kai-shek. Madam Chiang was the first lady and the inspirational bulwark of the Chinese people in their struggle against the Japanese armies during World War II. And this is what the speech said. And his grandmother notes that she didn't copy it word for word, but this is what she had wrote down from the speech. "If the past has taught us anything, it is that every cause brings its effect. Every action has a consequence. We Chinese have a saying, if a man plants melons, he will reap melons. If he sows beans, he will reap beans. And this is true of everyone's life. Good begets good. Evil leads to evil. True enough, the sun shines on the saint and the sinner alike. And too often it seems that the wicked prosper. But we can say with certainty, with the individual, as with the nation, The flourishing of the wicked is an illusion, for unceasingly life keeps books on us all. In the end, We are the sum total of our actions. Character cannot be counterfeited, nor can it be put on and cast off as if it were a garment to meet the whim of the moment. Like the markings on wood, which are ingrained in that very heart of the tree, character requires time and nurturing for growth and development. Thus also, day by day, we write our own destiny, for inexorably, we become what we do. And then the author, this is what it says right after. It says, Grandma put her glasses down and went into the kitchen to warm the rhubarb pie. I'll admit, I didn't understand too much 40 years ago, but I'm a seasoned gardener now. The truth of these words, the bitter and the sweet, is everywhere. That's a very important passage. Basically, you reap what you sow. And then if you go back to the quotes, don't tell a woman she's pretty. Tell her there's no other woman like her and all roads will open to you. That's just for, you can make of that how it pertains to you. The laziness is nothing more than the habit of resting before you get tired. There's a lot of people that sit around and talk about what they should do, what we should do, maybe we should think about this. Do or do not. And then that it is not how old you are, but how you are old. How are you living your life? What are you contributing? The more you contribute into this world, the more you will get out. It just seems that that's the way the universe intended things to work out, and that's the way it seems to do so. Now, today's Friday, the 18th of September, 2009. This is your Daily Dose. Excellent book. I encourage everybody to get The Seeds of Greatness by Denis Waitley. Also, don't forget to call our sheriff's office. I'm going to try to keep the video a little bit short. We're going to stretch it a little longer than yesterday. Hopefully, this will go through on time. Everybody have a great weekend. Enjoy college football. I know that I will. Also, for those of you in Las Vegas, don't forget San Janeiro Feast. You'll probably see me there this weekend, probably tonight, in fact, grubbing down on some of them ears of corn. They are delicious. I would encourage anybody to get out there and eat some of it. And also just to get out there and have a good time. This was, once again, Friday, September 18th, 2009, and this was your Daily Dose. And don't forget about letting our sheriff know, NRS 453A needs to be pre-shifted to all Las Vegas Metro Police Department. And you can call that public information office at 838-3394, or you can email them at pio@lvmpd.com. All right, everybody, have a great weekend.